पोर्शन पीरियड. सो वाई इज इक्वल टू फॉर ऑल स्टूडेंट्स मस्ट लिसन केयरफुली. फर्स्ट वन वाज वाई इज इक्वल टू साइन एक्स ग्राफ. एंड इफ यू रिमेंबर्ड दिस ग्राफ वाज लाइक दिस मैक्सिमम वैल्यू. अगेन आई एम रिवाइजिंग दिस ग्राफ्स टुडे, दे आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. जीरो स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम जीरो, दिस इज वन साइकिल. पीरियड इज टू पाई. पीरियड मीन्स टी. वॉट इज मीनिंग ऑफ दिस? दिस विल रिपीट एट एवरी इंटरवेल ऑफ टू पाई. सो टी इज इक्वल टू टू पाई. मैक्सिमम वैल्यू इज वन, मिनिमम वैल्यू इज माइनस वन. सो दिस इंटरवेल, इफ यू ऑब्जर्व हियर, दिस इज जीरो, दिस इज पाई, दिस इज टू पाई, दिस इज वन ब्रांच. दिस विल कीप ऑन रिपीटिंग. That means here I will get this graph. This is another branch. You can make it by another color so that you understand it like this. This is third branch you can make here. So this point is 2 pi, 3 pi, this will be 4 pi. This will be minus 2 pi. So you can see every interval from here to here, it is 2 pi. Here to here, this is 2 pi. From here to here, it is 2 pi. That is the meaning of this period. Sine 0 is equal to 0. It starts from origin. At pi by 2, it is 1. At pi, it is 0. So sine x graph, if you elaborate it, this will be like this. 0, pi by 2, pi, 3 pi by 2, and 2 pi. This is one cycle. And this keeps on repeating. Similarly, next I have explained the second graph was y is equal to cos x. I think these graphs I have discussed in class.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So just I am revising them so that you can remember them. They will be very useful afterward. Cos x graph. Cos 0 is equal to 1. It starts from here. And cos x graph, one branch is this. 0, 2 pi. This is pi. This is pi by 2. Pi by 2 is 0. Second branch will be again like this. This side also. So this interval is 2 pi. This interval is 2 pi. This interval is 2 pi. And so on. So period of this is also 2 pi. Maximum value is 1. Minimum value is minus 1. Capital M represents maximum value. Small m represents minimum value.
Oh, I felt like I had to protect him. He's my husband.
How the hell did he even get involved?
This is
Jimmy. Mute from your side. Unnecessary. If it is not required, mute it.
Never
stop. Some TV sounds are coming from Gunj.
The gold standard.
Now me.
Gunj, mute yourself.
You're nice. Like it or not.
Third graph, I have told, see, period of, so now we can conclude that period of y is equal to sin x, cos x, sec x, and cos x. Their period is pi, 2 pi. Period of tan x and cot x, period is pi. This note down, everybody. Period of sin x, cos x, and their reciprocals, sec x and cos x, is 2 pi. And period of tan x and cot x is pi. So graph of tan x. Was like this. period is pi. So in this, what I will do, I will draw two lines at pi by 2 and minus pi by 2. This I have already explained, because at pi by 2 it is not defined. These lines will be at equal distance, not like this. So this graph of 10x is something like this. What we have, what we call these lines? You remember the name of these lines?
Asymptotes.
Yes. So these lines are known as asymptotes, asymptotes. What are asymptotes? Are tangents at infinity. Because here x cannot be pi by 2. So this is pi by 2. X is equal to pi by 2. This line is x is equal to minus 3 pi by 2. That is why domain of x, 10x, domain, what x belongs to, r minus 2n plus 1 pi by 2. That means x cannot be plus minus pi by 2, plus minus 3 pi by 2, plus minus 5 pi by 2, odd multiple of pi by 2. So from the set of real number, I am removing all odd multiple of pi by 2. This is the domain. Domain means x values for which the function is defined. Range. Range means on y-axis. What is the minimum value? Minus infinity to plus infinity. So range is set of real numbers. And what is period? T is equal to pi. So this one pi interval is over. You can check. This is x equal to minus pi by 2, not 3 pi by 2. X equal to minus pi by 2. This is minus pi by 2. So this is minus pi by 2. This is 0. This is pi by 2. So one pi interval is over. After this, 3 pi by 2. Next line will be 3 pi by 2. Here also you will get same graph, because it is periodic. After this, you will get 5 pi by 2. Then also you will get same line. So these all intervals are pi. This is also pi. That is why this 10x is periodic function with period pi. And minimum value, you can see 10x. Downward it goes up to minus infinity, upward goes it up to plus infinity. So this is known as unbounded function. Unbounded function means its minimum maximum values are not defined. Minimum maximum values are not defined, unbounded. Sin x, cos x are bounded functions. Minimum value is minus 1, maximum value is plus 1. This is just revision actually, what we have done earlier. Shall we move next? Similarly, cot x. Y is equal to cot x. This graph is not defined. Cos x upon sin x. What is cot x? Y is equal to cos x upon sin x. So sin x must not be 0 basically. So x cannot be n pi. That means its domain belongs to r minus n pi. n is any integer. N can be 0, n can be plus minus 1, n can be plus minus 2. So n is equal to 0 plus minus 1 always, plus minus 2, plus minus 3, and so on. N can be any integer. So this graph, if I want to draw, it is not defined at 0. So at 0 is this the asymptote, this line is asymptote, this line is asymptote, pi is asymptote, 2 pi is asymptote, minus pi is asymptote, pi to pi, period is pi, t is equal to pi. So this graph will be at 0, 2 pi by 2 t is positive, like this. 0, start from here, 0, 2 pi by 2 t is positive. Then second quadrant, negative. Similarly, this will keep on repeating. So in this case, these vertical lines, this line, this line, this line, these are asymptotes. So x is equal to 0, x is equal to pi, x is equal to minus pi, and so on. So x is equal to n pi, these are the asymptotes. So you can see domain, what a domain, r minus n pi, and what a range, set of real numbers, minus infinity, going minus infinity to plus infinity. Range belongs to set of real number. So they are also unbounded. No maximum, no minimum value defined. See, this fact that if you know, remember the period, then you have to draw the graph in one cycle only. For example, period is pi. So just 0 to pi I have to draw. Afterward, it is stamping. 10x, just I have to draw minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. One pi interval is over. Afterward, it is stamping. Same thing will happen with cos x and the sec x. Their graphs are a bit difficult. Just I'm drawing them. Earlier, I have explained you. Y is equal to cosec x. So this is also 1 upon sin x. So here also sin x cannot be 0, x cannot be n pi. So domain of this function is r minus n pi, same as cot x. First and second quadrant positive. ASTC. So now we can draw the graph. Now sin x lies between minus n 1, cos x will not lie between minus 1 to 1. So range belongs to minus infinity to minus 1 union 1 to infinity. This will be range. So in this graph also, we will draw two lines. Y is equal to 1, y is equal to minus 1. But purpose of those two lines is different. In sine and cos, we have drawn those two lines so that no part of the graph lies between them. So I'm drawing this graph. I'm drawing a straight line, trying to draw. So it cannot be 0, it cannot be pi. So at 0, I will draw this yellow line, asymptote. At pi, I am drawing another asymptote here. At 2 pi, minus pi, so 0 pi. Now, one thing you can see, 0 to pi, that means first quadrant, second quadrant. Sin x and cos x must be positive. And one more line I am drawing, as I told. This is y is equal to 1. This is y is equal to minus 1. because cosec x will be either greater than 1 or less than minus 1. So in this part, my graph will be 0 to pi, always positive. This. At pi by 2, you observe here cosec pi by 2 is equal to 1 upon sin pi by 2 is equal to 1. So at pi by 2, it is a 1. So at pi by 2, it is 1. So this graph, very smooth, and you have to draw like this. Afterward, between pi to 2 pi, it will be negative. So it will come here. This, these lines, yellow color lines, these are all asymptotes. These are asymptotes. In this case. Now this is one cycle over 2 pi, 0 to 2 pi. Another cycle we will have just stamping. That means here I will have this, I will make a stamp of this shape and do it here. This and this. Second cycle over. Similarly, third cycle, fourth cycle, and so on. So this is the graph of y is equal to cosec x. If you observe here, this interval is 2 pi. So this portion is again stamped here, from here to here. That is why this is periodic function with period 2 pi. Again, these are unbounded functions because there is no minimum or no maximum value. Only thing is, this graph does not lie between minus 1 to 1. Last part. Y is equal to sec x. Sec x is what? 1 upon cos x. So cos x must not be 0 like sin x upon cos x. So x cannot be 2n plus 1 pi by 2. For example, cos pi by 2 is 0, cos 3 pi by 2 is 0, cos 5 pi by 2 is 0. So it's a domain of f. Domain belongs to r minus 2n plus 1 pi by 2. This domain is same as domain for 10x. Again, sec x will be either less than equal to minus 1 or greater than equal to 1. That means no part of this lies between minus 1 to 1, same as cosec x. So range belongs to minus infinity to minus 1 union 1 to infinity. Or you can express in another form, or r minus minus 1 to 1. This is removed. R minus in this way also we can express. Graph, I think now you can make it easily. Just draw the lines, this asymptotes, minus pi by 2, pi by 2. Marking all these lines. What are these lines? This is 0, pi by 2, add pi, 3 pi by 2, 5 pi by 2, 7 pi by 2, minus pi by 2, minus 3 pi by 2, minus 5 pi by 2. Between minus pi by 2 and pi by 2, again draw two lines, no part will lie between 1 and minus 1. So graph will be something like this. At 0 it is 1. third quadrant pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2 and fourth second quadrant and third quadrant will be negative. So here it is negative. This is the main basic cycle. Afterward, this will keep on repeating. This cycle, this will again come here. This will come. This will come here. This is y is equal to 1. This is y is equal to minus 1. So no part of the graph lies between minus 1 and 1. So this is a graph of y is equal to sec x. This period is also 2 pi. Just note down them. Then I'm going to explain some more things about this. In graphical transformation, some concept I will teach you. Graphical transformations, periodicity, and graphical transformations of trigonometric functions. After completing noting down, tell me, I will move to the next page. Okay, Pranati, you are done. Pranati, you are remembering the formulas? Because your mic is not working generally. Today I will check. Okay, good. Rishi Rao? Yes, Rishi? Can you unmute yourself? No, your mic is also not working, Rishi. So I think everybody is done, so I'm moving to next page. Okay. Now I'm going to explain some very important concept. Right, periodicity of trigonometric functions. So first point, so many things, new things I will explain in this. Period of sine x, cos x, sec x, and cos x is how much? 2 pi. Second thing is period of tan x and cot x is how much? Pi. Third thing, period of sine 2 raised to power nx, cos 2 raised or sine nx, you can write in another way, this slightly different way, period of sine raised to power nx, cos raised to power nx, sec raised to power nx, and cosec raised to power nx. period. T is equal to pi if n is even. And T is equal to 2 pi otherwise. Note down this. Period of sine raised to power nx, cos raised to power nx is pi if n is even. Period of tan nx and cot raised to power nx is always pi. What is the meaning of this? If I ask you, write the periods. Well, examples I'm taking. Sine power cube x. 2. Cos square x. 3. Tan x. 4. Under root of sine x. 5. Cos three upon 5x, 6, 10 raised to power 11x, 7, cot power 4x. Write their periods, only periods. Yes. Amok, what is the answer of first one? First one is 2 pi. Yes, very good. First one is 2 pi. Why it is 2 pi? Because it is odd. Otherwise, I have written here the rule number 3. See this. T is equal to 2 pi otherwise. Here power is 3. So it is not even powered. So period will be 2 pi. That's correct. Ayush, what is the period of second question? Yes, what you are saying?
Pi.
Okay. Period is pi. Yes, very good. Cos square x period is pi because this power is even. So you can understand one thing. If I ask period of cos square x or cos 4x or cos 6x or cos 100x, all this is cos or sine. Cos 100x, period of all these functions will be pi because all are even powered. Whereas period of under root cos x, cos minus 3x, cos 5x, cos 101x, period of all of them will be 2 pi because your power is half, your power is minus 3. Like that. So period is pi, period is 2 pi. Next, third problem. So period is pi, 10x. Definitely 10x, we don't have any problem. Even if under root 10x, period will be pi always. 10x and cot x, this fourth number you can see. Period is always pi. Under root sine x. Under root sine x. Prakar, what will be under root sine x? Prakar, you can unmute yourself or reply me in the chat box. Pi. Yes, very good. So period of this is pi. Why it is pi? Which formula you are using pi? Even? See, this here, this T period is pi if n is even. Here it is not even. Half is not even number. So it will be 2 pi. Understood? Like in this page I have explained. Period of under root cos x is how much? 2 pi. So period of under root sin x. Period of sin 1 upon 5x. Or sin 7x. Or sin 11x. All these period will be how much? 2 pi. Because this is not even number. Understood, Prakhar? Got it? So your answer was wrong. Okay. Next. Previous one. Period of cos 3.5x. Definitely this period is 2 pi. This is not even. Period of 11x, pi. Period of cot 4x is also pi. Whether it is power is even or odd, it doesn't matter in tan and cot. Period of tan and cot is always pi. Next point. Fifth, period of mod sin x, mod cos x, mod sec x, mod cos x, or mod tan x, and mod cot x. Period of all the six functions is pi. Period of all these functions will be pi. Mod sin x, what? Mod sin x will make, because mod will make, overturn the things. Whichever negative is there, negative things will be made positive. For example, I want to draw a graph of y is equal to mod sin x. So mod sin x graph will be like this. Everything will be positive. 0 to pi, period is pi. Just that is all. So afterward, it will repeat itself. Maximum value will be 1. Maximum value is 1. Similarly, if you want to draw graph of y is equal to mod cos x, this will also be same here. Minus pi by 2, 0. 3 pi by 2. So period is pi. T is equal to pi in both cases you will see. For mod tan x, mod cot x, mod cos x, everything, period is pi. Just keep on note down this. Completed, everybody? Just inform me after completing.
Dancer.
Okay, so I'm going to next page. Six number now. Now listen very carefully. This is next important concept in the same continuation, periodicity. If period of y is equal to fx is t, then period of y is equal to bf ax plus c plus d is ty mod a. Remember, t must be always greater than 0. T cannot be 0. If period of any function is t, then period of y is equal to b f a x plus c plus d is t y a. So one thing you can observe here, b c d have no role in the period. What is a? A is the coefficient of x, and it has to be positive. Negative also we will make it positive. Negative also we will make it positive. T upon mod a. What is a? A is the coefficient of x. A is a, only this have some role in the period. Examples. Examples are like y is equal to sine 3x, for example, this. So what is the coefficient of x here? 3. And we know period of sine x is how much? 2 pi. So period of this function will be how much? 2 pi by 3. This will be period. If I ask you what is the period of y is equal to sine x minus pi by 6, or y is equal to sine pi by 3 minus x, or y is equal to 2 sine x plus pi by 4, or y is equal to sine x plus 3. Yes, A, B, C are some constants, yes, correct. So in all these cases, you can see period will be pi, 2 pi. Why? Because coefficient of x is not changing. In y is equal to sine pi by 3 minus x, period is 2 pi upon a. A is coefficient of x mod minus 1. Is equal to 2 pi. Again, period is 2 pi. So our main focus is on this coefficient of x. What is the coefficient? Other things don't have any role to play in the period of the function. I will tell what is the role of b, what is the role of c, and what is the role of d. First, you understand this point. Yes, correct. Everybody note down. I will take more examples. First note down this, then we will discuss this. Any doubt is there? Yeah, note down, then I will move. And inform me, tell me when you have completed it.
Answer.
Yes, I think Chris was solving. Chris is typing. Yes, okay, so then I'm moving further. So if I ask some now, two, three questions I'm asking, y is equal to 3 cos pi by 6 minus 2x plus 1. Write this period of this. Second, y is equal to 4 mod of sine 3x plus 5. Third, y is equal to 10 cube 2 minus 6x plus 1. And fourth question is y is equal to under root of sine 5x plus 6 plus pi by 3. Write their periods. Everybody write. Answer may be wrong or right. Don't worry for that. Yes, what is the answer of the first one? I think so. This, okay, Rishi has done very good. So you have done all the questions. Yes, very good. So in this case, first, period of cos is 2 pi. So 2 pi upon what is coefficient of x? This minus 2. So it's equal to pi. So period is pi. In second case, definitely period of, I'll check what you've written. Second answer is wrong. Because it is mod sin x. Mod sin x period is pi. If I ask you, what is the period of mod sin x? Pi. Period of mod sin 2x will be? No. Period of mod sin x is pi. Period of mod sin 2x will be pi upon 2. Period of mod sin 3x will be pi upon 3. Period of mod sin 5x will be pi upon 5. So your answer will be yes, Rishi, it is pi by 3.
ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಎಚ್ ಬಿ ಮೂವೀಸ್ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ವಾ? ಓಕೆ ಹಾಕೋಣ, ಅದರಲ್ಲೇ ಹಾಕ್ಲಾ?
Yes. See, in period, nothing matters. Only coefficient of x, neither inside or outside or multiplication, nothing matters in period. That is why I told period of BF AX plus C plus D. What was the period of this function? Simply T upon mod A. That is what. BCD has no role to play. So in this case, period of 10QX is pi. Pi 6. Period of this function, period of under root sin 2 pi, 2 pi by 5. So I'm unmuting. If anybody has doubt, you can ask me. If anybody having any doubt, you can ask me. Yes, Dhyan understood. Dhyan, Vaishnav, Sanika, Samarth, Pranati.
Okay.
Any doubt?
No.
Okay. So now I'm explaining you what is the use of them. Why we are learning all this? What is the use of them? Okay. See. Suppose I want to draw graphs of sine 2x. I'm explaining now that part. Sine 2x. Let us draw graph of y is equal to sine 2x. So definitely, its maximum value is 1. Minimum value is minus 1. Capital M stand for maximum value. Minimum M, small m, I'm writing for minimum value of this. What is the period of this? Period is the most important thing here. Period T is equal to 2 pi by 2 is equal to pi. That means it will complete one cycle in pi interval. Instead of 2 pi interval, it will complete one cycle in pi interval. See, maximum value is not changing, so I'm writing here 1. Minimum value is not changing, so I'm writing here minus 1. Y is equal to 1, y is equal to minus 1. Now, first let us draw graph of y is equal to sine x. Sine x, this is 0, pi to pi. 0 pi, 2 pi, 3 pi, 4 pi. Similarly, this side, one branch we can draw. This is how much? Minus 2 pi. So this is the graph of y is equal to sine x. Now suppose I want to draw a graph of y is equal to sine 2x. This period is 2 pi. What is the graph of sine 2x? Pi. That means in pi interval, it will complete one cycle. In t is equal to pi, it will complete one cycle. What is one cycle in sine x? One cycle in sine x is this. This is one cycle. 0 to 2 pi. So this one cycle will be completed in 0 to pi. So here it will complete. This is half cycle. Pi by 2. So this graph will be like this. Maximum value, minimum value. One cycle is over in pi interval. Now this will keep on repeating. So next I will get this like this. Next you will get this. Similarly, this side also. And so on. So this graph is for y is equal to sine 2x. Just note down this. I will take more examples of this type. 2-3 more examples. Yes, we will do that. Sine 3x, sine x, y 2, all we will do. This is over.
One minute, sir.
Okay. Next come to sine 3x. You also try to draw it. Okay, what will be sine 3x? Graph. period of this will be 2 pi by 3. That means 120 degree, 60 into 2, 120 degree. So this will complete one cycle in 120 degree. This is 0. This is y is equal to 1. Y is equal to minus 1. Sine x graph I am dropping first. Zero pi, two pi, one cycle. Other cycle also you can make, no problem. One cycle is enough. Minus pi, minus two pi. Zero to pi, one cycle is over. Pi to two pi, second cycle is over. Zero to pi, one cycle is over. In this sine x, this is black color is a graph of y is equal to sine x. Now I have to draw graph of y is equal to sine 3x. That means in 120 degree, 2 pi by 3, t is equal to 2 pi by 3. 2 pi by 3 is 120 degree, one cycle over, 240 degree, second cycle, 360 degree, third cycle. So we will divide this into three parts. 1, 2, 3. So up to this, three cycles will be over. So one cycle over up to this, so half cycle will be here. So I can draw this in this way. One cycle is over. This point is 2 pi by 3. Next, this is 4 pi by 3. And next, this is 6 pi by 3 means same thing will happen here. This is minus pi by 3, minus 2 pi by 3, like this. So this will continue. Another color I am making this. No, red color only. So this will be like this. One cycle, second cycle, and third cycle. We observe here, from here to here, this is the point 2 pi by 3. From here to here, one cycle over. From here to here, second cycle over. From here to here, third cycle over. So this is the graph. Red color is the graph for y is equal to sine 3x. This is the graph of y is equal to sine 3x. Now you can ask me the doubts. Rishi, you were asking something. Now you understood, everybody?
Yes, sir.
Note down this, then I will go for next point. I will ask you, okay, here only I'm asking now, in the same graph, you draw now y is equal to sine xy2. Draw the graph of this here only. In your copies, draw this. Okay, very good. Sine xy 2. So your period will be how much? 2 pi a. What is a here? A is equal to half. Coefficient of x is half. A is equal to half. So yes, period will be 2 pi upon t upon a, 1 upon 2 is equal to 4 pi. That means one cycle will be over in 4 pi. So you can see this graph will be something of this type. If this is the sine x, small I am making now so that otherwise it will be very difficult to make it. Maximum minimum values will not change. This is 0, this is 2 pi, this is 4 pi. So now this is the graph of sine x. Black color. Okay, very good, Nakul. Now sine xy2. In sine xy2, in 4 pi, one cycle is over. So half cycle maximum value is this. Minimum value is this. This will not change, remember. Now, in half cycle, if you observe here, 0 to 2 pi, this half cycle is here. And one cycle is here. This is one cycle over now. This will be the graph of this. This is the graph of y is equal to sine xy2. In 4 pi, half cycle is over. One cycle. If you draw here in 2 pi, this will be half cycle. It will be like this. 2 pi. And then again afterward it will go somewhere, it will meet at 4 pi. So this graph is for y is equal to sine xy2. Similarly in 2 pi, this will be here like this. And it will go. Yes, directly you can draw. Here it is the, you can compare how the difference is coming. That is why I have drawn this. You can compare with sine x because sine x we are familiar. What changes are happening in sine x, sine 2x, sine 3x. You can visualize those changes. Just note down this, then I will give some more questions of this type. One more transformation I will give, which will be very useful. Completed this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So next is next transformation. Drawing graph of see, if we know the graph of y is equal to fx, drawing graph of y is equal to fx plus k. That means if I add some constant k. So in this, depending on k, the graph will be lifted up or pushed down depending on k. If k is positive, two cases will be there. Case one, k is greater than zero, then lift up. If k is less than zero, push down. See, what is the meaning of this? Suppose I ask you, draw graph of y is equal to sine x plus 1. So here k is equal to 1. So what I will do? I will lift the graph of sine x vertically by 1 unit. Sine x graph, see. This is the sine x graph. 0, pi, 2 pi, 3 pi. This is maximum value 1. This graph will be lifted up. I'm going to lift it up, this graph. How much? Pi unit. That means every point you can consider this is made up of iron rod. Some curve is there. Every point will be lifted up. Yes, very good. So every point, this point will go here. This point will go move here. This point will come here. This point will come here. This point will go here. Every point. So this you will get a new graph like this. This point is lifted 1 unit. This point is lifted by 1 unit. This point is lifted by 1 unit, every point. So this is the graph of y is equal to sine x plus 1. So you can consider here y belongs to, when this is minus 1, 0 to 2, minimum maximum value. This maximum value is 2. Y is equal to 2. Y is equal to 1. Some net problem was there for a small 1 second, so that is gone. Y is equal to, suppose, sine x minus 2. So in this, again, what we will do, first draw the sine x, and then we will push down by minus 2 unit. Sine x graph, see this sine x. This maximum value 1. So this is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Push down every point by 2 units. So this point will come here. This point 1, 2 units here. 2 units, every point by 2 units. This point will go here, 2 units. This point will come here. So you can draw this graph like this. Vertical lines are for our reference only. So you can see every point, this point is moving down minus 2 units. This point is moving down. This point is moving down. This point is also moving down by minus 2 units. So this red color graph is y is equal to sine x minus 2. So what is the minimum value? Y belongs to minus 2 minus 1 minus 3 2 minus 2 plus 1 range of this minimum maximum values. M is equal to minus 1 and M is equal to minus 3. Thank you. note down this. Next point, see. Completed this? If I ask you this next third category, third transformation, y is equal to kfx. See, there's a difference when I say y is equal to f of kx, here coefficient be multiplied by k. Here this function I'm multiplying by k. So these are two different. Here period will be t upon k. Here period will not change. So in kfx, only magnitude will change. Magnitude will change. Two cases will be there. K is greater than 1. Stretch along y, if k is between 0 and 1, negative I am not considering here, 0 and 1, compress along y. If k is more than 1, stretch along y, compress, because magnitude will change. For example, if I ask you draw graph of y is equal to 2 sine x. See, sine x function is multiplied by 2. It is not sine 2x. It is 2 sine x. So maximum value will be 2, minimum value will be minus 2. That's the difference. So graph will be of this type. This was my sine x graph. See, every time, first I am drawing sine x so that you can understand. This is the sine x. 0, pi, 2 pi. No change in period. Period of this function is still t is equal to 2 pi. But what is changing? Its highest value. Highest value is now is 1. Minimum value is minus 1. Now it will be 2 or minus 2. Period is not changing. So just I will stretch. I will fix these points. This point is fixed. This point is fixed. This point is fixed. Now I will stretch it like this. So this is the graph of y is equal to 2 sine x. If I ask you, draw graph of y is equal to half sine x, then maximum value will be half and minus half. So then we will have graph of this type, like this, half and minus half. This will be the graph. This is the graph of y is equal to half sine x. If it is 3 sine x, I will make it 3 and minus 3, and so on. So this k changes the magnitude. Yes, this you understood, everybody?
Yes, sir.
Now, in this last one case I am taking, then I will mix everything. In this last case is a fourth, y is equal to f of x plus c or x plus k, suppose x plus k, f x plus k. See, this k is inside, x is being increased. So two cases will be there, k can be positive, k can be negative. Case one, k is greater than zero, positive. Then shift left. And if k is negative, shift right. First note down, I will explain this. In short form, I'm giving how you can remember them. For example, y is equal to sine of x minus pi by 6. Suppose this is the question. I have to draw this graph. So basically, if you observe what is happening, sine x graph, if I draw, first sine x. This is the sine x graph. One branch is sufficient. This is zero. This is pi. This is 2 pi. Now, this is the sine x. Now, what is happening if you observe here? In y is equal to sine of x minus pi by 6. Sine x minus pi by 6. At x equal to pi by 6, it is 0. So k, what is k? K is equal to minus pi by 6. That is negative, second case. So I will shift right. That means at x equal to pi by 6, y is equal to 0. So instead of starting from 0, 0, my graph will start from pi by 6, means 30 degrees. So every portion of this graph will shift towards right, every point. This point, so this point will go here, this point will go here, this point will come here, this vertex will also move, this vertex will also move this side. So now you will get, this point is here, so you will get a curve of this type. This distance is how much? Pi by 6. This is shifted towards right by pi by 6. So this is 0. This is pi by 6, sorry. This is pi by 6. This point will be pi plus pi by 6, 7 pi by 6. This is 2 pi plus pi by 6. So this point will be 13 pi by 6. Similarly, if I ask you, draw graph of y is equal to sine x plus pi by 3. Check. So then you will shift towards left, minus pi by 3. This minus pi by 3. Minus pi by 3. Then your graph will be like this. This point is minus pi by 3. So this graph is for y is equal to sine of x minus pi by 3. X plus pi by 3, sorry. X plus pi by 3. So what will be the coordinate of this point? 2 pi minus pi by 3. 2 pi minus pi by 3, 5 pi by 3. Every point is shifted. So this point will be basically here. This distance is pi by 3. So every point is shifted towards left by pi by 3 unit. So now I think you must have understood this. Now I will give a question which combines all these concepts. So one by one, I have explained all the concepts. After completing it, tell me, I will write another question. We'll discuss another concept here.
Done, sir.
Very good. Now draw. Now I expect you must solve this y is equal to. Two sine x minus pi by 6 plus 3. Solve this problem. Two sine x minus pi by 6 plus 3. Plot this. You have to draw the graph of this function. 2-3 minutes I am giving. Everybody try to solve. Step by step, we must do the transformation. This is known as transformation of curves. Starting from steps, I will write for you. How you have to go step by step, see.
So done.
First of all, you have done very good. For others also, I'm writing. First step, you see how you're doing very fine. First step, you must draw a graph of y is equal to sine x. Second step, okay, good. Second step, you must draw y is equal to sine or 2 sine x you can draw, or y is equal to sine x minus pi by 6 you can draw, that is better. Y is equal to sine x minus pi by 6, next step. Third step, you can draw y is equal to 2 sine x minus pi by 6. And fourth step, you must draw final graph y is equal to 2 sine x minus pi by 6 plus 3. Step by step transformation. So basically, on single line, you must draw these four graphs. That is what I want. So first, everybody knows, first of all, we can calculate its range will be 1 to 5. So first I'm drawing this like this. Draw the line, vertical line, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, -1. This is 0, 1, -1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Very good. Most of you have done it. Very nice. This is x-axis. This is y-axis. Others also listen carefully. Sine x. First graph is sine x. Sine x I am drawing with black only, no problem. Y is equal to sine x minus 1 to 1. Very simple graph. This is minus 1. This is just extended I am making so that you can understand. 0. This is pi. This is 2 pi. Sine x graph. After this, sine x minus pi by 6. This I have already explained. K is minus pi by 6. So I will shift towards right. So I will shift this graph towards right. So if I shift towards right, I will get by pi by 6, 30 degree. So 30 degree, suppose here. 30 degrees here. So this will come here like this. So this green color is second. Green color is second, I'm writing here. Second. Sine x minus pi by 6. This is second number. Now, third, y is equal to 2. So the moment I multiply it by 2, these points will be fixed. And this will be stressed along y-axis by 2 units. So what will happen? I will get a one more line, that is y is equal to minus 2. Y is equal to minus 1. So now I will get this point will be here, 2. And this point will go here, 2, minus 2. So I will get a graph of this type. If I ask you one question, okay, mark these points also, this will be how much? Pi plus pi by 6, 7 pi by 6. So this point is a 7 pi by 6. What will be this point? Where the highest point is coming? This was the pi by 2 plus pi by 6. So pi by 2 plus pi by 6 is equal to 6. So this is how much? 4 pi by 6, 2 pi by 3. So this point is 2 pi by 3. Now, this is the blue curve. This third number is blue curve. So this is 3. Fourth one, what we have to do? We have to just lift it by 3 units. Lift up by 3 units. Each and every point, 3 units. So this point will go to 1, 2, 3 here. This point, 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 1, 2, 3 here. This graph you have to draw now, these red dots. So this will be something like this. So this is point A, point B, point C, point D, point F. If I ask you what is point B? Point B is 2 pi by 3 comma 5. This is the coordinate of point B. Because this point is lifted by 3 units. And what was this point? This was the pi by 2. So in the pi by 2, I have shifted it by pi by 3. So this I have added here, pi by 6. So pi by 2 plus pi by 6 is 2 pi by 3. That is why this point is 2 pi by 3. 5. So any point coordinates we can calculate. F, what is F point? 2 pi plus pi by 6, F. 2 pi plus pi by 6, comma, 1, 2, 3. So 13 pi by 6, comma, 3. So F point is 13 pi by 6, comma, 3. So in this way, we can calculate this final red color is the final graph. Remember, all others are just intermediate step. Red color is the final graph. Other graphs are for our reference purpose only. They were the stepping stones. So finally, I'm getting this graph. You can see this lies range between 1 to 5. So I hope everybody understood this graphical transformations today.
Yes, sir.
So with this, we have almost finished all concepts of this trigonometric ratios and identities in detail. I will be sending you some 10 problems today, I think. So immediately you have to solve and submit. Time will not be given, much time will not be there, okay?
Yes,
because now we have already taken so much time in this trigonometry. And among other students, those who are not able to remember the formulas, everybody must remember them. No, graphs I will not give. Okay? Graphs I will not give. I'll just give the other things, other questions on trigonometry. So with this, I am finishing the today's class. Okay. So thank you, everybody.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Bye.
Bye.
Yeah.